When the pandemic started, was there a shift, or did things kind of progress normally as it was before in terms of the sorts of things that you were seeing?
The pandemic came along and just changed people's access to their services. So agencies were forced to make changes and change their response to how they were able to encounter people. And even the simplest things that people who were struggling relied upon when it came to keeping themselves well, as simple as going to the library to access a computer to reach out to a person, or, right at the outset when everything was closed, even just accessing a bit of Wi-Fi outside of a place of business, like all of those, even those smallest supports were changed. And so I feel like there's a bit of a scramble at that time as people started to suffer more without access to those supports. Definitely there was heightened risk, I would say.
I do think that relatively speaking, we did quite a quick, fast job at Community Mental Health of making our Google Meet system quite available to people. So we immediately started to access Skype, like a Skype type or a Zoom type system, so that we could at least see our clients face to face. And then we realized that the barriers that were attached to that was that not everybody has Wi-Fi, not everyone has a working cell phone, and not everyone has internet connection that they can access. So you think rural places. We did attempt to adapt to that quickly as well by offering support to get people phones, to get people internet connection. I find that sometimes, though, what got missing was we weren't hearing from the people that didn't have the Wi-Fi, so we weren't able to adapt how to do that. We quickly established things in our agency where people can actually come in if they need to. They had to meet certain criteria, which I think sometimes were tricky, but we do still see people face to face. And then the outreach program that I run with Sam Bigley definitely boomed. There was a lot of people that we were able to see in person to make sure that we could support them and see what they needed. You think that the thing that we hear the most as something that people are hurting for is people are lonely, and not seeing people face to face, even in groups, or going to a games night or going out with friends, but people are really lonely.
In terms of, I'm thinking about our harm reduction program. So normally in Bracebridge, we're there 5 days a week, and we have people walk in and they're able to get needle kits, so new needle kits, new crack kits, and naloxone. And it was going, I would say it was quite successful. Like we had a good word out there that it was happening, and we had people coming in. People were bringing in bins with used needles that we could return. So it was going really well. And I think that's been something that as soon as kind of the doors closed, we haven't been able to kind of get that momentum happening again. The program is running again, where you just have to call the office and make sure that someone's there to supply what you need. But I think that was a big roadblock in getting people kind of some safety tools out, and made the community outreach like that much more important, because we knew people were not coming in any longer to get what they needed.